1812, General Andrew Jackson was a big hero of that war. And he won two very large, or his men that he was commanding won two very large victories. One was the Battle of Horseshoe Bend, the other was the Battle of New Orleans. Fire it once more, they begin running. That one. The other one was this one called Horseshoe Bend. And he had command of 500 Cherokee troops, including a young man who was an adopted Cherokee by the name of Sam Houston. And those 500 Cherokee troops he sent around behind the enemy. And he attacked them from the front, and as they fled to the back, they went into hand-to-hand combat and slaughtered them. It was a very decisive battle. It pretty much ended the war in Alabama. And 20 million acres were ceded by the Creek Nation, and 2 million were given to the Cherokees. And that was in 1814. Now in 1828, President Andrew Jackson was elected, largely on those two victories. He was a war hero, you know. And in 1830, it was a very popular act called the Indian Removal Act. And it was very popular at the time. There were some dissenters. There was a very strong dissenter whose career was ruined by it. His name was David Crockett, and he died at the Alamo. And President Andrew Jackson said that that the Indian Removal Act would place a dense and civilized population in large tracts of country now occupied by a few savage hunters. That's what he said. The Cherokees had schools and churches, and they wore suits, and they had a written language. Most of them spoke and wrote in Cherokee and in English. And in 1838, they were marched to what is now Oklahoma, and 4,000 of them died along the way. They did that for gold. The U.S. needed gold, because we didn't have precious metals to back up our money, to make money with. So they removed them for gold. Anybody's got a $20 bill in their pocket? That's the asshole on the front of it. Diana was a Cherokee, pretty as you'd ever see, with blue eyes and long black hair, and a wild streak from here to there. The reservation life was slow, so she packed her bags to go. Moved to Georgia and took the name Diana Jones. Diana ran the Dewdrop Inn, wily as a mountain cat, and kept a room behind the bar for any man who needed that. And people talk about her still, how she'd take a $20 bill and right across Jackson's face, Diana Jones. As she brought all the gold in Georgia back shining, the 20 bucks at a time. Harlan wore the badge in town, he was always hanging round. But ever since Diana died, you hardly see him on this side. His wife used to come for him and drag him out of the Dewdrop Inn. It wasn't fit for a family man to know Diana Jones. Diana made the front page news the night she went out on the loose, heartbroken with a gun in her hand and in love with a married man. And neighbors called the station scared, Harlan had to go down there. Something went wrong somewhere for Diana Jones. All the gold in Georgia back. $20 at a time. Between Diana and five armed men, shots were fired and words were said. The two men and Diana dead, and things went on the way they do. The papers filled with other news. And the wild died in Harlem too, with Diana Jones. I've only seen him one time since. He come into the Dewdrop Inn and bought all the old boys around and went to lay his money down. Gave a $20 bill a kiss and said, I hate to part with this. And right across Jackson's face, it said, Diana Jones. As she brought all the gold back shining, $20 at a time.